Hello, everyone. Do you want to see how money, black caviar, and tennis rackets are made? Then we're going on a tour of modern factories at once. Several security systems, an impressive spike fence, an entrance strictly for employees. Of course they make money inside. It's funny, but the production of the future crisp euro banknote starts with this paste. These are cotton fibers bleached under pressure in hot water. They're the reason that bills are crisp. Besides, cotton paper can withstand rough handling longer. The first elements of protection are added at this stage already, a special thread and a watermark. The latter is created by changing the thickness of the paper. But the printing press is where the real magic happens. There, the banknotes go through several stages of production, and the first is the simultaneous offset printing on both sides. Then, the denomination of the bill is applied with a special paint containing special pigments that will make it shimmer from green to blue. At the stage of intaglio printing, all the remaining protective elements appear on the banknote, including a relief structure. All that's left after that is to assign a unique number to each banknote, check the batch for quality, and cut the sheets into beautiful piles. The Royal Belgian Caviar Company has been breeding various species of sturgeon fish since 1990. They've developed a special food for them. They constantly check the water on farms for quality. Where else would you watch the production of black caviar if not there? When the fish reach maturity, they're brought from the natural lakes to the nearest production center. One fish can carry from 800,000 to 3 million eggs. The entire caviar mass is thoroughly and carefully washed so as not to damage their fragile structure. At the next stage, the caviar is sorted by size, color, and quality. So if you find a smaller egg in a jar compared to the rest, you can write a complaint. Speaking of the jar, after salting, the caviar is packed in such containers so that customers could immediately see how high the quality of the product in front of them is. So, do you think we're in some kind of garment factory? This is a Porsche factory, for your information. Moreover, the 911 Turbo S from the exclusive series is about to be assembled here. And since almost all exclusive things are created manually, the participation of robots in this process will be minimal. We are inside the workshop where saddlery is produced. Robots only give the material the right shape, and most of the work is done by an operator at the sewing machine. Of course, they use golden threads. Have you forgotten what kind of car this is? People also do most of the work when it comes to the production of the seats. They have to perfectly position all the electronics and smooth out every crease of the leather. Yeah. However, the painting stage is more automated. First, the machine applies the base layer to the 20-inch wheels, after which they're sent under a laser. A special technology turns them the famous golden yellow color. The body is completely painted by robots, after which the car can be assembled. Cars and people work together to get such beauty as a result. Imagine a fragrant piece of the freshest red fish fillet on toast you've tasted. But for the fillet to get there, it first has to be obtained. And this is how it's made at the Ice Fresh Company in Germany. A whole salmon is put on a conveyor. At first, it loses its head. It will no longer need it. Then it's in for a quick shower in the filleting machine itself. The backbones get cut out and fall on another conveyor, and the juicy pieces we need are sent to the pre-trim belt. Then, robots with a visual recognition system rid the fish of excess skin and other unnecessary parts. But in the end, their work will still be checked by real people. We want to get the perfect fillet, after all, and even that's not all. After that, this weird thing uses a vacuum to remove all the small bones from the fillet. Almost done. One more rinse and the delicacy can be packed. The small and not particularly valuable fish are less lucky. They're sent to the shredder for the Max in India company. Of course, you can't serve this to the table. This is just how raw materials for feeding livestock or fertilizing the soil is processed, but just listen to this sound. Would you like to get from 10 to 50 delicious paninis every minute? Then you need the Cello Panini Production Line. First, the panini are put on a transport belt, and as a security measure, people can't touch them here. An extremely sharp ultrasonic knife operates inside. Although it only turns on when the product is detected by the sensor, the blade carefully opens the bun in a second, after which it's time for sauces. The Cello fill pump is used for dosing both liquid and thicker mixtures. But the filling has to be put in manually. Nevertheless, the capacity of this line is still impressive. This looks like the workplace of Mr. White and Pinkman, but we're actually on the territory of Casper's Ice Cream Company. The popular Fat Boy ice cream is produced here. The cookies are moving ahead waiting for the ice cream because it's harder to prepare. First, a mixture of milk, sugar, and butter is heated, then passed through a homogenizer and moved along a transport belt with a system of cooling tubes. Only after reaching the desired consistency does a portion of the ice cream go on the cookie. After which, the sandwich we're familiar with is slightly squeezed, evened up, and packed. Tennis fans probably know how much a good racquet can cost, and we're about to find out why they're so expensive. This sheet is the basis of the future Yonex equipment. It's graphite, pre-impregnated with special resins. The complex chemical composition allows the racquet to achieve perfect technical characteristics. It turns out light, and at the same time, it's very strong. After the mold is glued and pressed from several layers, holes for strings are drilled in it. This guy sends the racquet for quality control, a mandatory, long, and thorough process. This approach allows them to create a product that is in high demand among world-class tennis players. For example, their employees are trained for at least 6 months, even just for decorating the racquets. Creating high-quality tennis balls is just as complicated. Yeah, this is not cheese, but rubber bases for their creation. These forms are loaded into a hydraulic press, which turns them into hemispheres. Then those are removed from the molding sheets, and their edges are polished and covered with a rubber solution to glue them together and create pressure inside using compressed air. Almost done. All that's left is to apply a special solution and felt, and the game is on. Fewer and fewer states are using disposable plastic appliances, and wooden cutlery is a good alternative. The first stage of their production begins in the forest with the selection of high-quality raw materials, usually birch. They get rid of the bark, grind the workpiece, and get extremely thin sheets. The press will cut products of the desired shape out of them. They, in turn, will rush along the conveyor to be dried, and then take their final forms. Just a few simple processes and eco-friendly devices can already be packed and sent to customers. One would think that making a hammer isn't that complicated. A handle, a head, a claw, that's it. While the Italian company Osca has a slightly different approach to the production of tools, they prefer to apply even inscriptions and information using laser engraving. It all begins with forging the metal part of the hammer. It's unusual to see blacksmiths in shirts and trousers, wouldn't you agree? The thing is, the work they do here isn't too strenuous. They just drag the parts from one press to another, then the robots deal with it. They grind and polish the workpiece until it takes the perfect shape. Well, and the handle is connected to the head with just one movement of the machine. All that's left after that is to give the finished product a branded look.